This is very special. And as you all know, Churchfitters, my favourite band of all time.
Oh, you wouldn't say that, at all.
No, you are, seriously. And they never cease to amaze me. So I think they deserve a very deep round of applause.
Thank you very much. Nice to be here.
Flying, he's flying.
times that was a traditional Scottish song that we got from Archie Fisher. He used to sing that one. I don't know if he still sings it, because he's still singing. But yeah, so it's quite a contemporary sounding song, but it's actually traditional. And we're going to finish? We're not going to finish. No. Well, we could do. The trouble is we've eaten so much, we're actually going to feel kind of sleepy, you know. But yes, I do apologies for the people in the front row, because we've eaten quite a lot of garlic bread, so you might go. We're going to continue, not finish. Well, it could be, you never know, do you? We never know what's going to happen. With a melody that Chris wrote, called Hammer It Flat.
you and good night.
Yes.
Yes, thank you. That was Hammer It Flat. Hammer It Flat. Chris, that was inspired by the days when Chris used to work for Bob the Builder.
Tiny little fella
he was. He work for a guy called Bob, who was a builder, and had many, many astonishing adventures with him. He was a one-off Bob the Builder, and they hammered a lot of things flat, actually, yes. And most of them ought to have been hammered flat.
So there you go, that's the inspiration for that one.
We're going to do a song, and I would like to dedicate this song to anybody who's ever been betrayed. I'm guessing that's most of you. Anyway, I've certainly been betrayed quite a few times. Yeah, and I don't see it coming. That's just, I'm naive. So, would you like to say something?
Yeah,
sir,
say
sir.
Rosie was betrayed in the last number.
Oh, God. Anyway, yes, for anyone that's been betrayed, and this is the main reason we do this song, really, is because Chris has this musical soul. And it's a terrible shame to bring it to a party and not be asked to play it, isn't it? So we have to do this number so that he can play the musical song.
Thank you. anyway, we're going to carry on with a song you will know, The House Carpenter, old favourite of ours, all about an unfaithful woman. Are there any unfaithful women here today? Surely not.
Judging by the reaction to the betrayal song, I should say yes.
Heaven, my love, where you and I cannot
You're all right, Boris.
You're all right, there.
Boris is looking a bit, you know, perturbed.
Sometimes everything is not working.
Oh, sometimes everything is not working. Oh, this is it. This is the night.
Don't pay attention to me. I'm a bit busy.
Okay. Well, we'll ignore you then. Rather sinister. He's completely dressed in black from head to toe. He walks up to Elizabeth and he invites her to dance, and she accepts. And they begin to turn around the dance floor. And one by one, all the other couples who had been dancing, they stop dancing and they watch them, because there's something mesmerizing about their manner of dancing together. They do a few more turns around the dance floor, and then suddenly Elizabeth and the stranger leave by the side door that gives onto the garden, into the night, and Elizabeth is never seen again alive. However, quite small pieces of her are found the next day in various parts of the garden. Notably, her heart, which has been torn from her body, but is still beating. This is the legend of Bleeding Heart Yard. It is a real legend, so I didn't make it up, somebody else did. And Bleeding Heart Yard is a real place. And you can still go to Bleeding Heart Yard today in London. The manor house is long gone, but Bleeding Heart Yard is thought to have been where the stable courtyard is. So it's part of the stable courtyard still there. You can also go, while you're there having a look, you can go to a rather swish and quite well-known French restaurant and have a meal. But don't eat the liver and bacon.
thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, we've got one more to do before we take a break. And we thought we'd better do a happy one after all that. So, yes, a betrayal, infidelity and murder so far we've had. So we're going to do this rather nauseatingly happy song. And it is also a chorus song. And Chris is going to tell you what the chorus is.
Am I?
Well, yes, when I check my tuning, yes.
Oh dear, that's put me under pressure. I sing it, but when I try and say it, it's not the same, is it? But it's meant to be the same, isn't it? Yes, Lady Luck. Stand by my side. Happiness, won't you be my guide? It's very happy, isn't it? Very happy. From the shadows, here I fly. Crossing over to the sunny side. And that's rather a lot to remember. But if you can't remember that, it's just, let's run like the wind and try to catch the tide at the end of each chorus. And there's an opportunity for you to wobble with Boris on this one. Wobble along with Boris.
To add to Boris's woes tonight, because apparently he's having
wobbly
a few technical
woes.
Hitches, wobbly woes, his wobble board has got rather tired. It's due for retirement soon. So he does this wobble board solo in the middle of this song, but unfortunately he can only do little short stretches of it before it gives up the ghost. So we're relying on you in the gaps to do the wobbling for us. So you've got two jobs, the chorus and the wobbling.
We had a very wobbly audience last night.
Oh, we had a very wobbly,
in
yes,
diss. You don't want to be outdone by diss.
They were better than the real thing, weren't they? Diss is in Norfolk. It's in Norfolk. Come sinners, come pigs, come all ye rogues and rakes. It's the turning of the tide. Come tinkers, come tailors, come soldiers and sailors. It's the turning of the tide.
Happiness.